Hi everyone, I'm Kelly.
And I'm Olivia, and we're from the Smithsonian Marine Station in Fort Pierce, Florida.
We're from the Coral Health and Marine Probiotics Lab, also known as the CHAMP Lab, and we study a coral disease called the stony coral tissue loss disease. We research different treatments to stop it from taking over the reef.
We're taking the time to work from home and connect virtually to post a series of videos that will talk about corals, the CHAMP Lab, and the stony coral tissue loss disease. Today, I'm going to start off by discussing why corals are so important, and then Kelly's going to discuss some factors that are threatening the health of coral reefs.
Coral reefs are found in all the world's oceans. The largest coral reef system is the Great Barrier Reef on the northeast coast of Australia, and it spans more than 1,500 miles long. The Belize Barrier Reef is the longest in the Western Hemisphere, and it forms the core of the 700-mile-long Mesoamerican Reef. The Mesoamerican Reef lies within the Caribbean Sea and runs along the coast of Mexico, Belize, Guatemala, and Honduras. The Smithsonian National Museum of Natural History has a research station 15 miles off the coast of Belize, on an island called Caribou Key Field Station. Scientists come from all over the world to conduct research on the coral reef ecosystem that surrounds the station, as well as neighboring mangrove and seagrass ecosystems. But our personal favorite is the Florida Reef Track that spans more than 300 miles long along the Atlantic coast from Martin County to the Dry Tortugas near Key West. The CHAMP Lab conducts all of our research along the Florida Reef Track, focusing on areas where the stony coral tissue loss disease is present. Coral reefs are some of the most valuable and diverse ecosystems on the planet. Even though coral reefs cover less than 1% of the ocean floor, they support 5% of global biodiversity and are home to 33% of marine fish species. That means they are a critical source of fish for the oceans and to people for food. Coral reefs support local economies, valued at an estimated $375 billion worth of goods and services. Hundreds of millions of people rely on coral reefs for their jobs and livelihoods through tourism, recreation, and fishing. Coral reefs are a source of chemical compounds that are being used to develop new medicines, especially for the treatment of cancer, HIV, and heart disease. Coral reefs also serve as protective barriers, safeguarding shorelines from erosion from waves, storms, and surges.
Wow, those videos of those corals are pretty cool. You can see all the different colored shapes and sizes of the corals.
Yeah, I actually took these videos when I was in Belize on Caribou Key Field Station. It's pretty amazing to see these healthy coral reefs in person. By far one of my favorite places to go diving.
Well, now that we know how important and how beautiful our reefs are, let's take a look at some of the threats that put our coral reefs at risk.
Local threats to the Florida Reef Tract and other reefs around the world include wastewater pollution that overload nutrients on the reef, overfishing, which causes the depletion of key reef species, erosion from an increase in storm events, pollution such as trash and plastics that block sunlight and cause wear and tear on coral reefs, a species invasion that can outcompete with native reef species, and even ship groundings that can cause physical damage to coral reefs. A more global threat to coral reefs around the world is climate change. You can see in this diagram, there are gases in our atmosphere that trap the heat from the sun against the Earth, warming the planet. This is called the greenhouse effect and has occurred for millions of years. In fact, it allows for life on Earth. However, if we increase the amount of gases in our atmosphere, whether it be by driving cars, flying in planes, or even powering our houses, we increase the amount of heat trapped against the Earth. This causes the Earth to become warmed much faster and out of sync than what occurs naturally. You can see the temperature of the Earth has climbed well above average in recent years. As a result, our Earth has increased by 2 degrees Fahrenheit since the beginning of the 1900s. This increase in temperature of the Earth can have global consequences. As water can absorb lots of heat, our oceans are warming more than usual. Unfortunately, our oceans are expected to further increase by 2.2 to 5.8 degrees Fahrenheit by the year 2100. This few degree change in temperature may not sound like a lot, but you can think about its impacts on corals as if it were a human fever. Just a few degree increase in human body temperature could send you to the hospital. So now that we have an idea of how ocean warming impacts coral reefs, Stay tuned to the next few videos that take a deep dive into this topic. We will discuss the different parts of a coral up close and learn about coral bleaching, a response to ocean warming that occurs on the inside of the coral.
Thanks, Kelly, for going over that. You know, it's really sad to hear about everything that's damaging our coral reefs, but I also think it's really good information to know so we can try to decrease those stressors as much as we can.
Absolutely. And there are a ton of great organizations out there that focus on restoration, and the CHAMP Lab is doing what we can to protect the reefs as well.
Well, thanks everyone for tuning into our first video. For our next video, our lab mates, Tessa and Kylie, will be getting down to the facts about corals and give you an insider's look at the live corals that we have at the Smithsonian Marine Station.
And in the meantime, if you guys have any questions, please feel free to direct message us or click on the link below. Talk to you soon.
Bye.